A human disease is closely related to the condition of one's light field. The light fields may get weakened due to various negative reasons. A human body is directly linked with the universe. Speaking of which, every sun circles one another and attracts each other one by one. While the light bodies also exist within our bodies in layers and take in many solar fields corresponding to the whole universe. The concept is basically similar to the multiverse or the 36 heavens mentioned in various religions, but only the wordings are different. In fact, the solar fields in our bodies are more than 36 layers. There could be about hundreds of thousands or millions of layers. The more layers there are, the more powerful and smooth our energies become. DNA, the smallest unit inside our bodies, is a tool that transmits and receives energies. Once DNA returns back to normal, one's health condition is successfully improved. The light fields get to circulate normally. Light bodies are back. Blood, lymph, hormones, lipoproteins, and other matters begin to flow. The lumps start to shrink. It means that now both hereditary and acquired diseases are going to come along gradually and nicely. Human diseases can be classified into three types: congenital, hereditary, and acquired diseases. Congenital diseases, first of all, can be inherited from the combination of sperm and egg and triggered by genetic factors, intrinsic changes, and extrinsic influences during fertilization. Intrinsic changes cover chromosomal aberrations or genetic defects, while extrinsic influences are inclusive of drugs, diets, maternal complications, or environmental factors, which can potentially affect one's mental ability or appearance. The second type, hereditary diseases, are passed on from one generation to another through defective genes or genetic variations. These groups of people are commonly born with normal mental abilities or appearances. Genetic testing can reveal mutations in genes sometimes, while there are exceptions, which explains why many people do not show symptoms until later in life. As for the third one, acquired diseases are normally caused by psychosocial factors or bad habits, including an irregular lifestyle, work pressure, psychic trauma, depression, poor eating habits, drug addiction, heavy drinking, and more. Self-healing is about cell regeneration and genetic recombination. No matter if it's a hereditary disorder or an acquired disease, it has something to do with genetic variations and mutations. A human body is just like a battery. When it accumulates a great deal of solar energy, its performances of driving force and endurance are very good. Comparatively speaking, when the number of layers decreases, our energies become weaker. The density and quality of our light bodies also decline, signifying the deterioration of one's physical functions. If it keeps happening, one's energy pathways would collapse and shrink, as if they are blocked by storms. In this case, not only energy of each light field, but also blood, lymph, hormones, lipoproteins, and so on, won't be able to go through. Let's make an example. If the blockage happens to the liver, all sorts of matters start to deposit, and there will be variations and lumps. As time goes by, these lumps become bigger and worsen the light field of the liver. The light bodies then distort, causing these solar fields in the body to fade even faster. To get our health back on track, we need those solar fields back in our bodies so that they can help regenerate the cells and recombine our genes. In other words, it's like downloading. In every solar field, there are setup assistants, or let's say device drivers. When we download them, our cells get to be regenerated. The genes are recombined, or to put it simply, it requires a lot of setup assistance to make sure gene arrangement, genetic combinations and gene orders happen to make sure we have well-functioning DNA. If the structures of the genes are not complete enough, they won't be able to analyze, send, receive information, nor transfer energies. These are just what make biotechnology intriguing. It's also a field that humans are desperate to explore. I'm Dr. PH. This is science, not religion. Time is ticking. Please like the video and share it to your family members and friends, and ask them to help spread the ideas. You can help more people. Don't forget to subscribe and hit that bell icon. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.